Let my words, our meditations deep, be good and right, be found to be acceptable and precious in thy sight. Amen.
Amen.
In our gospel reading today, Jesus talks about almsgiving, prayer, and fasting. But he tells us that these things should all be done in secret, rather than being trumpeted before all people. Whilst all these things are good things to do in and of themselves, and indeed are good things for us to do in the season of Lent, they are, nonetheless, not things that we should, he says, advertise, as perhaps some of the more zealous amongst the Jewish community that he lived in would have done at the time. This was a radical message in a time when many people like to show off their almsgiving and the amount of money they could pour into the temple treasury, or like to show off their how zealous they were in prayer. And indeed, it is for our own time also a radical message, a time when we still live in a situation where many people are much richer than other people in the world. There is great inequality in the world, and sometimes there can be a temptation to show off how much the rich are giving to good causes, or perhaps in our secular context, to show off the degree to which we pray or devote ourselves to God, to set ourselves apart from those who do not such things. But Jesus tells us not to show off our almsgiving, our prayer, and our fasting, even in this fasting season of Lent. That's something that we should bear in mind. Why is that? Well, it's because by showing off what we are doing, in a sense, we are subverting the very purpose of our prayer, our almsgiving, and our fasting. We make these things more about ourselves and our own power over others, the honour that we can derive from them, than about the service of God and about deepening our relationship with him, which is ultimately what these things are about, these acts of love and devotion to our neighbour and to our God. Now today I begin a series of short reflections at these lunchtime Eucharists, in which we will be looking at the stations of the cross. So we begin today with the first two stations of the cross, Jesus being condemned and Jesus being put on trial and then condemned to take up the cross. And I think that in these stations, and indeed in the whole Passion narrative, we see Jesus living out the words that he taught his disciples in that gospel reading that we heard from the Sermon on the Mount. Jesus might have been tempted when put on trial to pray to God for assistance, or to make something of the fact that he was the Son of God and was falsely accused of all the accusations that were made against him. But instead, we are told that he stays silent, at least when presented with those accusations. He says that he is that they will see him ascend and sit on the power on the throne of power and glory. And yet he doesn't respond specifically to all the allegations made, to the extent to which in some of the gospel narratives we're told that there was amazement from Pilate that Jesus refused to answer the allegations. And so we see that Jesus does not pray there and then in front of everyone, does not make clear his being the Son of God in a worldly sense, his kingship upon earth. Rather, we see him praying in Gethsemane by himself when all his disciples have fallen asleep, when he is alone. And it's there that he makes his prayer to God, that he comes to terms with what he is being called to do and makes his loving commitments to God the Father to carry through that calling. Again, Jesus gives himself better than any alms that we can give. He gives himself to us poor sinners, and yet he doesn't do this with a trumpet and a fanfare. He does this by taking up the cross humbly, like a criminal, and allowing himself to be crucified like a criminal, and indeed to die. And Jesus, we must remember, would have been fasting at this time. We have the story, of course, of him being given the vinegar to drink, which could not possibly slake his thirst. But we can only imagine what hunger and thirst he must have felt throughout the trial and indeed throughout the crucifixion and his time on the cross. But again, this is not made a big thing of in the gospel, because Jesus does this not to show off to the world, but rather to show his commitment to God the Father and his love for all of us. And ultimately, of course, we know that Jesus would be resurrected. And so God the Father did reward his Son for his obedience. And so I think as we begin this season of Lent, that this is an important message to bear in mind, that we should humbly and obediently show our love to God in whatever way we are able to, through our prayer, through our almsgiving and our fasting, and whatever form that may take for each one of us. But always to remember that we are doing it not for ourselves, not to show off to anyone else, but through love of God and emulation of his Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, whose fasting, whose temptation, whose passion we will remember in these coming weeks. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.